knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
Let's continue moving through our study of second declension nouns in Latin. We've looked at different kinds of masculine nouns in this declension, so now let's take a look at neuter nouns. For context, we already knew that Latin has three genders. In addition to masculine and feminine, let's now discuss neuter. First, let's review the concept of neuter. The etymology of the word suggests not and either. Clearly, it means that these words are neither masculine nor feminine, but sort of impartial or neutral. However, this concept is not connected to people. Neuter in Latin belongs to objects referred to as it, but it's not so simple, as not all the it words are neuter. Many of them are actually masculine or feminine. Remember, liber, book, is a masculine word, while aqua, water, is a feminine word. The neuter words are words that have their gender related solely to their endings. That's right, certain endings in Latin are clearly recognized as neuter. The first declension totally lacks neuter words, but the second declension has plenty. These words, in some of the cases, have endings of their own. To clarify this concept, let's see the declension of one of them. Templum, templi, templo, templum, templo, templum, templa, templorum, templis, templa, templis, templa. Just by looking at the declension, we will notice that genitive case still ends in I, which makes the words totally comfortable in the second declension. However, surprisingly, nominative and accusative case look the same, both in the singular and plural. This could be annoying in determining the subject in sentences. Is templum going to be the subject of a particular sentence or the object? It might require some extra thinking and some careful analysis of the other words present in the sentence. Here is an example. Templum incola servat. The inhabitant guards the temple. Templum incolam servat. The temple guards the inhabitant. In the first sentence, incola is nominative, so the inhabitant must be the subject and the temple must be the object. In the second sentence, incolam is accusative, so the inhabitant must be the object and the temple must be the subject, even though the verb will stay the same. The vocative has the same form as well, but this case is less common and it always describes an invocation, so we don't have to fixate on it. Most importantly, just by looking at the nominative and accusative plural, you'll notice that both end in A. This is an ending that we saw previously for the nominative singular of the first declension, so beware. If the noun is first declension, A is for a singular nominative, the subject, but if the A is found in a second declension noun, it will be a sign of a plural subject or object. Now you will understand why in English we say one bacterium and two bacteria. The list of Latin words belonging to this group is very long. Here are some very common ones. Acetum, aceti. Collum, colli. Malum, mali. Bellum, belli. Donum, doni. Frumentum, frumenti. Caelum, caeli. Fatum, fati. Forum, fori. Factum, facti. Lignum, ligni. Ovum, ovi. Tectum, tecti. Vinum, vini. Oppidum, oppidi. Verum, veri. Astrum, astri. Cerasum, cerasi. Crustulum, crustuli. Telum, teli. ferrum, ferri. Exemplum, exempli. Venenum, veneni. Verbum, verbi. Now let's see some of these words in action. Again, don't let the word order trick you. Oppidum agricola non amat. Vir munificus puero bono pulcra dona dat. Incolis Romanis periculum magnum in insula est. Bellum saeum oppidi pueros bonos terret. With some neuter nouns understood, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.